I think of proteins as like little machines inside of our body that do everything your body needs. I like to think of them like as beads on a necklace. Every bead is an amino acid, and that's what proteins are made out of.
There's 21 main amino acids, and then they make up these proteins, which proteins then are folded amino acids formed of all these different chains and structures.
These proteins, they move, they change shape, they respond to chemical signals throughout your body, and they're really what makes all of life possible on Earth.
I've always wanted to do science that helps people. I decided that I could use proteins to do that probably in the most creative way possible.
What the Institute for Protein Design is doing now is studying these molecules so that we can help create new versions of proteins to tackle new biological challenges that don't already have solutions that exist in nature.
Starting about 7 years ago, we started experimenting with developing AI methods instead of the scientific models, and we found pretty quickly that the AI models we were training were actually more powerful than our previous traditional scientific models. We could solve more complicated problems and do it more quickly.
Having the ability to design something very fast using these tools, identifying the best compounds that can be drug molecules very rapidly, is the most powerful impact that this field provides. In a world where antibiotic resistance and biological threats are on the rise, we urgently need new strategies to target proteins that are associated with critical illnesses. We need rapid solutions. We need to act quickly. AI and protein design gives us the ability to do this.
Seattle is rapidly growing into a global hub for protein design research to tackle 21st century problems in a way that is currently not possible anywhere else. Creating new medicines, creating new jobs, and creating entirely new ways to think about solving problems that exist not just here, but all across the globe.
My image for my lab and for the IPD is what I call the communal brain, where each researcher is like kind of a neuron that's in this huge collective. When you have all these neurons connected, these amazing things can come out. The same thing happens with science. The more smart, motivated, passionate people that are interacting all the time, you know, the greater the science and the harder the problems that can be solved.
I always am asking other people questions. I'm always going to people who are experts in a certain area. People are so, so kind. You can just walk up to them and say, I don't know what I'm doing here. Can you help me? And they will help you.
The Baker Wick Lab actually has a lot of opportunities for undergrads to get involved in the lab. I feel like it's been really beneficial to just get involved in research at such a young age. There's so many different projects going on, and I feel like I'm always learning about new things and new things that I didn't even think were possible.
I think protein design has kind of a limitless future. You can already see in the lab, we have people working on such diverse things. We have people working on, you know, photosynthesis for combating climate change, designing new enzymes to break down plastic.
When I finished my PhD, I really saw that protein design was reaching a point where it was going to likely experience a huge growth. And I wanted to be a part of that growth. And there really was nowhere else in the world where you could be involved in protein design like the University of Washington, because the University of Washington is where protein design started.
I actually came here first in 2015 as an undergraduate researcher. I saw all the amazing resources, all the vibrant collaboration. That experience stayed with me, so I wanted to come to UW again for my PhD.
I chose the University of Washington because I love Seattle, and I think the University of Washington in particular had so many opportunities for research for what I was interested in. Since you're on campus, you get to know professors, you get the opportunity to teach, and then you can also get in connection with lots of different industry partners that we work with. Lots of labs at University of Washington collaborate across the greater Seattle area. All of it combined just felt like it was the best fit for me.
I felt like UW had a lot of opportunity. I truly have really enjoyed research as an undergrad. I realized that I loved protein design so much. I couldn't see myself being at a different lab.
I've had over 100 students and postdocs go on to faculty positions now, and a much larger number go on to start new companies, and it's like this great extended family. After I gave my Nobel lecture and the lights came on and I saw that a quarter of the audience were people that I knew that I had worked with, it's very clear to me then that, my real role is, I'm making the scientific discoveries is one thing, but really training and mentoring all these wonderful people who go on and do these wonderful things is really great. The prizes are just, they're sort of a recognition of where we've got to at this point, but we think the future is going to be even more exciting.
For your family, for our future,
be boundless.
Be boundless.
Be boundless.
Be boundless.